So my topic is mod 8 synchronous up counter. So synchronous counter, if all the flip-flops which are involving in the counter design, they receive the clock from external source at the same time, then it is synchronous counter. If only the first flip-flop, it is receiving clock from external source, and second flip-flop onwards, if they are receiving clock from the previous flip-flop, then that counter or that circuit is called as a synchronous counter or a synchronous sequential circuit. So mod 8 synchronous up counter. So the state table will be like this. Mod 8 means modulus 8, capital N is equal to 8. That means number of flip-flops required to realize this synchronous counter is 3. 2 power small n is greater than or equal to 8, where small n is equal to number of flip-flops we are using in the design. So small n is equal to 3. 3 flip-flops we have to use in the design. Say A comma B comma C. So present state of A, QA, present state of B, QB, present state of C, QC, and these are present states. And next states of A is QA plus, B is QB plus, and QC plus. Present states of flip-flop A, QA, present state of flip-flop B is QB, and the present state of flip-flop C is QC. So QA plus is next state with respect to QA, QB plus is next state with respect to QB, QC plus is next state with respect to QC. So mod 8 and up counter. Up counter means small value to highest value, ascending order. 0, if this is 0. 0 means what is the next step of 1? That is 0, 0, 1. It will be the next state with respect to 0. Here it is 0, 0, 1. That is the decimal 1 is next state. Here in this clock pulse, at this clock pulse, 1 is next state. For next clock pulse, this 1 will be present state. 1 is present now. So after 1, next number is 2. So for this state, next state will be 2. That is 0, 1, 0. This 0, 1, 0. That is 2 will be here. It will be present state for next clock pulse. 0, 1, 0. So 2. What is the next number? 3. For 2, next number is 3. So for 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, will be next state. 2 and 3. 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3. So 3 comes here. This 3 comes here. 0, 1, 1. So after 3, 4. 1, 0, 0 means 4. 4 comes here. 1, 0, 0. For 4, 5 is next number. 1, 0, 1. This 5 comes here. 1, 0, 1. 1, 0, 1 means 1, 1, 0. 1, 1, 0. This 1, 1, 0 means 6. 6 comes here. 1, 1, 0. For 6, 7 is the next number. So this 7 comes here. See here. 1, first state, second state, third state, fourth state, fifth state, sixth state, seventh state, eighth state. So how many states my counter has to count? 8. Modulus means number of states that our counter can count. That is called modulus or order of that counter. So our synchronous counter has to count 8 numbers only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total 8 states. The task of this counter is completed because it has counted 8 numbers. After counting the lost number, again it has to reach the original number. That is 0, 0, 0. So after counting lost it, again it goes to 0, 0, 0. Again the same repeats. For next clock pulse, this 0, 0, 0 comes here. 0, 0, 0 means next number 0, 0, 1. So the operation continues. Again 0, 0, 1 comes here. 0, 1, 0 will be the next state. So this is the state table for the modulus 8 synchronous up counter. So now How many flip-flops? I am using 3 flip-flops, A, B, C. Now, let us start the circuit process. So, after state diagram, let us draw the state transition table. So, state transition table is similar to our excitation table. The excitation table, what is the phenomenon of excitation table? Present state, next state, flip-flop inputs. Q plus and D, or Q plus JK, like that. So, here, I am using JK flip-flop or D flip-flop, because D flip-flop is the simplest of all the four flip-flops. Output of, that is next state of D flip-flop, is nothing but input. Q of T plus 1 is nothing but D only. So that excitation table of our D flip-flop will be like this. Present state of D flip-flop, next state of D flip-flop, and flip-flop input. Present state, next state, and flip-flop input. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Here, the special characteristics of D flip-flop is the output, the next state, depends only on the input. Only flip-flop which doesn't depend on present state is D flip-flop. Remaining three flip-flops, S or JK and T flip-flops, their next state depends on flip-flop input as well as on present state, SR flip-flop. Q of T plus 1 of SR flip-flop is S plus R bar Q. That means Q of T plus 1 is depending on S, R and Q also. For JK flip-flop, Q of T plus 1 is equal to JQ bar plus K bar Q. That means JKQ is affecting next state. T flip-flop, next state of T flip-flop is TQ bar plus T bar Q. That means next state of T flip-flop is depending on T, input T, as well as on present state Q. So TQ bar plus T bar Q. Here, the D flip-flop, next state of D flip-flop is Q of T plus 1 is nothing but D only. Next state is not depending on present state. It is depending only on the flip-flop input. So 0 means same, 0. 1 means 1. Here it is 0 means again here it is 0. 1 means 1. So this is excitation table. Same phenomenon we can use for state transition table. Present state, next state, and flip-flop inputs. Flip-flop inputs. QA, QA plus. So DA is A flip-flop input. DB is B flip-flop input. DC is C flip-flop input. So write columns of DA, DB, and DC. How to write? Since it is a D flip-flop, output, this input is nothing but output. Output is nothing but input. That means same column we have to write here also. 0 means 0. Here 0 means 0. 0 means 0. 1, 1, 1 means 1, 1. This is 0. Here DB is same column. Same column of QB plus. 1, 1. 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Again, DC is nothing but QC plus. 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, and 0. Is redundant, no need to this. QA, QA plus DA, QB, QB plus DB, QC, QC plus DC. So this is state transition table. Now, after drawing the state transition table, we have to draw the K maps. K maps means we have QA, QB, QC. Only we have to consider QA, QB, QC only, not QA plus, QB plus, and QC plus. That means three variables K map we have to take. That means eight boxes K map we have to take. So let us draw K map for DA, first input. How many boxes? Eight boxes, sir. QA, QB, QC. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. No, right values. This is 3. 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is K-map arrangement. Now let us form the bonds. So DA is equal to QA dot QB bar QB complement plus next step. These two involving how far? Again QA dot QC bar plus this one, independent one. The term is QA complement QB dot QC. Similarly, K map for DB is equal to eight boxes again QA QB QC. Zero, one, two, one and two. This is 3, 4, 5, 6, 5 and 6. Here all are two half ones. We get two half ones. Here one more half one. So DB is equal to the term is QB bar dot QC plus QB dot QC bar. Now let us draw K map. Zero, two, four, and six. Here ones are there. 0, 2, 4, and 6. Bond is foldable half bond. QC is equal to DC is equal to DC is equal to DC is equal to this one only QC complement. So we have drawn K map for DA, DB, and DC. We got three expressions. So after the expressions, Let us complete circuit diagram.